High school is almost over.
Yes, and I'm confused what school I will choose.
I think UP is good.
But UST is better.
Lasal is the best.
How about Ateneo?
We asked some fourth-year high school students here at San Sebastian College-Recoletos which of the big four universities you want to pursue for college.
Good day! You are watching Team Cynosure. This time of year is a busy time for fourth-year high school students. Aside from the quarterly examinations, national career assessment examination, school projects here, and research papers there, senior students are also busy filling out application forms and taking college entrance exams. Students, of course, look for the best school which can train their academic capabilities and affordable to their pockets as well. If the United States has their Ivy League, namely Brown, Columbia, Cornell, Dartmouth, Harvard, Penn, Princeton, and Yale universities. On the other hand, the Philippines has its own Ivy League, more commonly known as the Big Four universities, namely Ateneo de Manila University, University of the Philippines, University of Santo Tomas, and De La Salle University. People are aware that these schools are the best academic institutions in the country. Almost every senior student dreams and hopes to be a student of one of these institutions. But due to intellectual or financial problems, it is difficult for them to pass the entrance exams and the enrollment as well. In today's episode, we're going to talk about what makes these four universities outstand among the others and how can they mold their students as an intellectual individual and citizen of the Philippines. So to all fourth-year high school students, who's interested in getting into one of these big four universities, watch and listen so that you'll know what to choose for college and where do you fit in.
We are here today in the premier state university of our country, the University of the Philippines.
Today, we're going to find out what makes University of the Philippines a long-standing school.
The University of the Philippines Diliman, or UP Diliman, is the flagship campus, seat of administration, and the largest constituent university of the University of the Philippines system. It is located in Diliman, Quezon City, in Metro Manila. It offers courses in liberal arts, social sciences, law, business and economics, natural sciences, engineering, music, archaeology, and fine arts, among others. It offers the largest number of graduate and undergraduate courses among all the universities in the Philippines. The university has an extension program in Pampanga, located at Clark Special Economic Zone, Pampanga, and an extension program in Olongapo, located at Olongapo City, Zambales.
Morning, I am here today with Ms. Angela Lara, third year BS Architecture. Good morning, Ms. Angela. So, what are the characteristics of UP that makes it one of the best academic institutions here in the country?
Ang UP kasi, isa na rin ito sabi na kamatagal na university din sa Pilipinas. At isa pa, ito ang university na itinayo ng mga Amerikano noong 1908 niya. Tapos, ang UP kilala rin sa mga, may mga estudyante na may sariling pananaw tungkol sa mga isyong panlipunan. At hindi lamang sila narating sa loob ng classroom, kundi sumasali rin sila sa mga isyong panlipunan. Ibig sabihin, hindi lang theoretical yung mga ginagawa nila. At hanggat maaari, meron may iambag sa pag-unlad ng bansa natin ginagawa nila. For now.
So what makes you be outstanding above the other universities?
Siguro ando na nga yung marami kasing courses ganyan na ino-offer ang UP na hindi mo rin basta-basta may kita sa ibang school. So ano namang ibig sabihin doon? Siyempre, di ba parang ang weird nga actually may mga marinigasyon tapos molecular biotechnology and quantum farm ganyan. So yun yung mga courses na diba parang specialized yung mga pinag-aaralan na kung saan hindi lang din kung ano yung in-demand gaya ng nursing o mga IT ganyan. Hindi lang yung mga tinutugunan nito na education.
So what are the facilities in the school that are used by the students for a better and more comprehensive way of learning?
Actually, typical lang din eh. School school kasi hindi nga gamit sa advanced din yung mga gamit na rin dito, mga parang ano lang din, ganun siya ko, typical, gaya ng mga OHP or overhead projectors, LCD. Sa mga, ginagamit yan sa mga presentation, either ng mga prof or ng mga estudyante rin kapag nag-report. Tapos, maliban doon, depende na rin kasi sa course, kung ano yung kinukuha mong subject o kung ano yung major, ganyan, kung ano yung pangalang.
So, are you happy with your stay here?
Happy? Oo, somehow. Pero, hindi rin, ganyan. Parang, pareho lang.